right, thank you. The Board of Education met in executive session for the purpose of discussions that might lead to the appointment of an individual employee pursuant to KRS 61.8101F of the Open Meetings Act, and no action was taken. So at this time, what I'd like to ask my colleagues is there a motion to enter into an agreement for the acting superintendent effective July 2nd of 2017? Motion made by Member Geese, second. Made by Vice Chair Wellner. All those in favor? Motion is unanimous. Give me a moment. I'd like to make a statement. I actually may want to wait for a second here. If you can give me a moment here. 1 second. Sorry to be so unorthodox, but I need to make sure of something. You'll learn in life that everything is a matter of timing sometimes, and this is one of those times. All right. So, again, I'd like to make a brief statement. As chair of the Jefferson County Board of Education, it is my honor to announce that Dr. Martin Pollio has been selected by the members of the board to serve as acting superintendent of Jefferson County Public School District. Dr. Pollio will officially assume the post on July 2nd of 2012. Getting to this point this evening has been a process. And during this process, it became clear to the members of our board that Marty has the right is the right person at the right time to lead our district. He will provide stability and direction while giving the board time to name a superintendent. Dr. Pollio has a proven track record of turning around struggling schools, increasing student achievement, and helping create and implement career pathways. He's a proven leader who is respected by his peers and has the skills needed to continue moving our district forward. We have a saying around here, we are JCPS. Well, Dr. Marty Pollio is JCPS. For 20 years, he dedicated his career to educating students, all students. He started his career at JCPS in 1997 as a teacher at Shawnee High School. He went on to serve as a teacher and assistant principal at Wagner High School before taking the helm as principal of Jeffersontown High School from 2007 through 2015. Dr. Pollio is currently the principal of Doss High School and is taking a leave of absence from that position while he serves the district as acting superintendent. Dr. Pollio received his undergraduate degree from Indiana University and his master's degree from Eastern Kentucky University. He earned his doctorate from the University of Louisville in 2012. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you our newly named acting superintendent of JCPS, Dr. Marty Pollio.
Good evening. Usually I would speak not from notes, I would speak from the heart, which I am going to do today, but I think it's important that I get my words right this evening, especially this time, so I would like to read a prepared statement so that you know exactly how I feel. First of all, I'm both humbled and honored to accept the position of acting superintendent of Jefferson County Public Schools. I want to thank the board members for having the confidence to provide me the opportunity to lead this great district. I also would like to take this opportunity to thank Dr. Hargens for her leadership and service to the students and the staff of Jefferson County Public Schools. As Mr. Brady said, 20 years ago, nearly to the date, it was 20 years ago this spring, I interviewed for a teacher and a basketball coach position at Shawnee High School. During my time at Shawnee and later at Wagner as a teacher, I found a passion for teaching and for leading teachers. Then 10 years ago, nearly to the date, I became the principal of Jefferson Town High School. During that time, I learned a great deal about leadership, instruction, promoting positive school culture and climate, and increasing student achievement. For the past 2 years, I've had the honor of working with the great faculty and staff at Doss High School. We have done great things together and set the school on a pathway to success. Most importantly, I believe we have created a healthy learning climate for the nearly 1,100 students that enter the school every single day. I bring to this position 20 years of experience in JCPS and 10 years of experience as a principal. I am like many of the great teachers, administrators, and support staff here who have spent the majority of their professional careers committed to the students, committed to the success of the students of Jefferson County Public Schools. Although it may be unorthodox for a board to select an acting superintendent who is currently a principal, I truly believe that I am the right person for this district at the right time. I believe that I have the ability to improve the culture and climate of our schools so that we can have healthy learning climates in each and every one of our schools. I am also committed to ensuring that Vision 2020 becomes a reality in every classroom and at every school through a commitment to deeper learning. As a result of this work, both student engagement and student achievement will increase. I believe that every employee in this district either teaches or supports teachers. I'm excited to begin this new challenge of ensuring that every teacher is able to teach effectively and every student is able to learn. Once again, I want to thank the board for giving me this opportunity to lead this great district. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Pollio. This board looks very much forward to working with you. The process to name a superintendent is already underway. This process will take several months, and we will provide this community and stakeholders with ample opportunity to share their feedback and ideas on how to best move our district forward. This portion of our executive session is complete. However, we are going to take a short break, about 10 minutes, and reconvene right here to go into our next executive session regarding potential litigation. We are convened for the next 10 minutes.
Sure. For the specifics, it is a, I guess the best way to say it would be a contract that is prorated daily over the course of the year until the the board hires a full-time superintendent. So at that time, the contract would then have me go back either to my principal position.
Are you interested in the full-time permanent role?
I believe that I'm going to do the best job I can possibly do and be successful, hopefully, as superintendent for as long as the board will have me. So So a goal of mine would be to continue on, yes, if possible.
Did you seek this position or were you sought out?
I've been interested for a while in becoming a superintendent, but I did not specifically seek this position out. But when asked, I was very much in favor of submitting my resume and applying.
So the district has been through a lot in the last couple of years. The morale is pretty low. You've got a lot of issues going on with student discipline. These are all things that colleagues and people have said that are your strong points. What are some of the things you want to do first?
Well, there is no doubt that big on my list of things to accomplish here early on will be, as I said in my statement, to improve the culture and climate of our schools. As you said, I think we have a lot of schools that can improve in that area. Every school can improve in that area at all times, but I think we have a lot of schools that can improve in that area. So definitely increasing culture and climate, improving the ability for teachers to teach and students to learn will be number one on my priority list. So obviously, first and foremost is going to be to really take a look at all of our schools and make sure that I find ways that I can work to improve that culture and climate in each and every one of our schools.
What's going to happen with DOS? Do you know, is there going to be interim put there? How will that work?
Yes, there will be an interim principal put at DOS while I am acting superintendent here at JCPS.
Who is that?
That has not been decided yet. Until it will be dependent upon Dr. Hargens at this point to make that decision.
So does the staff at DOS know that you've accepted this position?
They do now.
Okay.
We obviously, I could not make any statements to them prior to the board vote, which is difficult for me. I have a great faculty and staff at DOS, a great bunch of people who are committed to the success of the students there and have done great work. So that's a difficult part. We will have a meeting tomorrow to discuss it with all the faculty and staff. But I have gotten a lot of questions, obviously, over the past few days about it.
Do you see yourself as a hands-on superintendent? Will you be visiting a lot of schools? Will you be in classrooms?
I believe I will be very much a superintendent like I am a principal. And I think if you ask any teacher or student that has been a part of a school that I've led, I'm very active, classrooms, hallways, talking to teachers, working with teachers and students. Obviously, moving to superintendent, that increases the amount of schools, teachers, classrooms, and that becomes a very difficult challenge to make sure that you are present in schools. But I don't believe that there's any better way to evaluate how schools are doing and to monitor the culture and climate of schools better than being in schools and seeing what's actually happening. Excuse me. So I plan on doing that and being active and present in schools and the community.
And that leads to the students at DOS, who, you know, we'll see if their principals are leaving.
Well, what I would say is we have great structures at DOS. We have great systems. We have great people. Teachers are the heart of every single school, and having great teachers, we have great teachers at DOS, and I believe we've set the school up for success. So no matter what happens with me, short-term or long-term, I believe the school is set up for success, and great things are going to happen for DOS in the near future.
And you'll be here on graduation?
Correct.
The contract doesn't start until July 2nd. Can you tell us a little bit about up until then, what it's going to look like for you?
Well, I mean, a plan for me is obviously to spend, well, we'll say this. Number one, first and foremost, is for me to finish out the school year as the principal of DOS, make sure we get all of our seniors to graduation, have a positive graduation, and all of our underclassmen finishing out the year in a positive school environment, maximizing their learning through day 175. That is one of the things we talk about, consistency every single day at DOS. That will be a hallmark of the district while I'm superintendent. So that's first. Once we get through that, then it will be incumbent on me to make sure that I do everything possible through the month of June to make sure that I'm prepared and ready. And I'll be honest, I have a lot to learn. I've been working at a school, and there are things that I need to learn. I need to sit down with a lot of people and do some real studying up on the things that I need to know about this district, which I will do. You won't find anyone more committed to me than me in making sure that I know what I need to know in order to make good, successful successful decisions. So I plan to do that throughout the month of June before I start in July.
Was this a hard decision for you?
Yes, it's a very hard decision. I mean, 2 years ago, leaving J-Town was one of the most difficult decisions that I've ever had to make. And just like that, I think one of the toughest things about this decision is not having that day-to-day contact with teachers and kids. And so every single day I wake up, I go to school, I walk in the door, I get to talk to teachers and students about being successful and what they need to do in order to reach that success, whatever their goals might be, both teachers, students, and staff. So in this position, obviously there's not that hands-on every single day with teachers and students. So that was probably the most difficult part of it, was making that change from being in a school to coming to central office. But I do believe that the impact of superintendent, just like principal, is so great for a district that I felt it was a calling for me to take this position.
Is there a learning curve that goes with this, or do you have changes in mind that you want to see right away?
Well, I think there's a learning curve that goes with any job, and that's an important part. But I do believe good leadership is good leadership. So obviously, going from a school to a district of over 100,000 students and 15,000 employees is going to require a learning curve that is going to take some work. But in the end, I think leading teachers, leading students, and being a leader in general is the most important part of it and will lead to success.
You did mention in your statement that it's pretty unorthodox for an acting principal to move over to the superintendent role. I mean, is there anything particular that you want to address about?
Well, I just, you know, the traditional role or the traditional hire for a board is to go from, you know, a principal to an assistant superintendent to the superintendent position, whether it be a smaller district or a larger district. And so we're fortunate here to have great administrators here in our central office, and I think many of them would have been great choices also. So they did, I think, make a bold and courageous decision to select me coming out of a school, but I do think they recognized my ability to change culture and climate in schools and have positive, healthy academic climates in schools, and that will be my goal. So I've done it now twice in two different high schools, and I believe I can do it in a large district.
And it's interesting, you've had your certification for superintendent a couple of years now?
I believe it's been three. I can't say that exactly, but it's been about three.
And you're a doctor?
Correct, from the University of Louisville.
All right.
Thank you.
Great.
Brady, are you available before you all go into executive session?
Please.
Just one question.
Please.
Two, three,
maybe four.
That's not
Let's do two.
Killing me small.
All right.
We're very confident. You know, this is an unorthodox decision to make. You know, these are unorthodox times, so sometimes it requires an unorthodox decision. And Dr. Pollio has presented a compelling vision for our district, and our board totally supports his vision and his leadership going forward.
Just for like a transparency issue, can you tell us how many people you interviewed for this position? I'm not asking for names.
Sure. I won't tell you how many, but I will say that it was several. But I'm not going to go into the details of the process. Now, I'll tell you also that the process for choosing the superintendent will be much more robust, and we are going to make every effort to be able to provide ample opportunities for the community to make, you know, get feedback and ask questions and be a part of that decision-making process.
Do you have an idea of a timeline for that?
Well, we'd love to have it as soon as possible. I think that, you know, this we want to make sure. You know, and having Dr. Pollio on this position right now gives this board the ability to take some time and make sure that not only are we picking a superintendent, but we're picking the right superintendent. And that is the focus that this board wants to is committed to, and that's where we're going to be going.
Was the board in unity in this decision?
As you just saw, it was a unanimous vote, so absolutely. We're 100% behind our acting superintendent.
And I guess what message do you have
he is the right person at the right time to be able to help us with our transition from moving from Dr. Hargan's leadership over to our, you know, to Dr. Pollio's leadership to be able to take our district to the next level.
Do you anticipate the two of them to work together?
Yes.
To your knowledge, has this ever been done before, principal to superintendent?
I'm not aware of the history of JCPS regarding, you know, what the interim has been. I know that I think last time we did this, we had a retired administrator. I don't know what her position was in the administration. She could have been a principal, but, you know, at this point, moving forward, this, you know, Dr. Pollio is the right decision at this time, and we're really excited about this opportunity.
Is there any concern? I don't want to, like,
sure.
Push on this, but is there any concern about, you know, hostility or bad feelings in central office from the family problems like this?
That would be up to them to be able to express, but I certainly don't feel that way. You know, Dr. Pollio has, for many years, been a principal, and I think he's been a principal that has helped mentor not just several, you know, many teachers, but also several principals as well. I think that this is actually really encouraging that you see the board looking throughout its entire depth of its bench, not just looking as far as central office personnel.
Thank you.
Thank you. You have a great evening.
Come on in.
Do you all want?
Can we let them go into the phone?
Oh, yeah.
Go executive session and
I'm waiting. Yeah, and I'm waiting for Diane. As soon as Diane's.
So they can interview Brent while you're waiting.
And you all put
them on.
Okay.
I didn't know if your light worked.
Didn't we have to lose your software?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for giving us time to make our statements, and again for giving Dr. Pollio a chance to be able to address everyone in our community. So we appreciate your all your time and being here and reporting out on our this great decision. So thank you. So at this time, the board will now conduct a closed session as permitted by KRS 61.8101C of the Open Meetings Act for the purpose of discussion relating to proposed or pending litigation. Is there a motion? Motion made by Member Geese. Is there a second? Second made by Member Horn. All those in favor? Motion passes unanimously. We are now in executive session and we'll be back hopefully shortly.